Hello friends, welcome to the second lecture on the series of the topic, that is the time series. In this presentation, we will try to learn how to measure the trend values or how to measure the forecasted value of any time series with the help of the method of the least square. So this is one of the particular type of the method which we have discussed in this presentation. This method is also called as the curve fitting. So very quickly, we just recall that what we have studied in the last lecture. In the last lecture, we have studied that the component of the time series and what is the meaning of the time series. So we have seen that there are the four major components of the time series. One is a secular trend. It is also called as the long-term movements. And other is called as the short-term movements, which is again discretized into the seasonal and the cyclics are there. While there are some random or the irregular variations are there. For example, the earthquakes are there, wars are there, and then so on. So if you need more discussion about these four components, you can see the previous video on the time series. The link I have mentioned in the description of this video. So what is the need of the measurement? What is the need of the measurement of the trend? And why we need them, and what are the various methods which can you use to measure these values are there? So basically, there are the four different methods are there to measure the value of the trends, and these methods are graphical, semi-average, method of least square, and the moving average. So in this presentation, I just covered this first part, that is method of the least square, and after that, I just covered the rest of them. So the first question arises is why we need them? Why we need the method of the least square or the method of the semi-average? Or the simple term is why we need this measurement of the trend. So as we know that the trend means that is the behavior of the information. So if I say in the year 2009, there is some particular sale of some products, it's say 100 units are there. In the 2012, the sale will be 125 and so on. So if you want to measure what's the sale in the year 2021, so that is the measurement, okay, and that is the trend. So for example, in here, when the year increases, sale will be increases, while say if in the year 2014, the sale will be like say 110, so the sale will be decreased, and so on. So these are the measurement of the trend. So the first information we need is the past behavior. Once we know the past behavior, based on the past behavior knowledge, we can estimate the values. And then based on their estimation, we can measure their study components. So how to measure them? So I just considered first method, that is the method of the least square. The basic principle behind this method of the least square is to adjust the parameter of the model function. So remember that in the last presentation, we have considered that function is my f of t. So it can be anything. Okay, it can be the linear. So linear can be a plus b of t, a plus bx. It can be quadratic. A plus b of this plus c of t square. Okay, it can be exponential, a e raised power b of t. It can be polynomial, this is the polynomial. It can be the growth function, it can be a b power x, or etc. are there. So it's the objective is to adjust this parameter. So what are those parameters? This is a is the parameter, b is the parameter, here a, b and c are the parameters, a b parameter, and so on. So the task is to adjust the parameter of this to find the best fit, whether the fit is the linear best fit, quadratic, exponential, power, and then so on. And the task is to minimize their sum of the square. Sum of the square is also called as the residue. So what is the meaning is, I just explained them. Say these circles are my exact values. I say this is my year, this is my sale. So say in the year 2009 is 100 value, year 2010 is my 120 value, and then so on. So based on this, I can say this is 2009, 2010, and so on, and say this is this, this is second, and look at that, these some values are there. So my task is to fit a curve, either the linear, quadratic, or whatever is there, which will minimize their distance. For example, if I draw this line, okay, so this point is very near to this predicted value. This point is near to this value. Okay, this is very near to this. This is far away as compared to the other two points, and so on. So my task is to fit the best curve so that the distance between this line and this actual values is minimized. So that's why this is called as the minimizing the sum of this k and speed. So these are the actual values are there, and I just draw this straight line. So I can measure this, the distance between these circles to this either of the vertical or by the perpendicular. So look at that, I can draw these vertical lines. So this is the distance between them. And if I just draw the perpendicular on it, so how we draw this? This one. Okay, so these are the two distances are there. So, or we can say, if I say this is the distance, and if I say vertical line is there, so how we find the distance between them? So this is say x is there. So the corresponding value is say called as the y1, and the corresponding value is called as the y2. So coordinate of this is my nothing but x y2. Coordinate of this is my x y1, and you can find the distance between them here by using the distance formula x2 minus x1 square plus y2 minus y1 square. Okay, so since x is remain same, so what is the distance between them here? So it's nothing but the y2 minus y1. So either you can use the vertical distance or by the perpendicular distance, but it is quite understood that the vertical distance will give you a less error. So the vertical offset from the almost minimize their error. Okay, so we will try to learn the vertical offsets methods are there. So several kinds of the methods are there as we discussed. One is the linear, or called as the straight line a plus bx, or also you can write like linear is ax plus b. That it's depending upon you, either you can use a plus bx or ax plus b. Similarly for the quadratic, also called as the parabolic or second degree is there, exponential, function, and then so on. Here y is the time series value and x representing the time. So based on these different methods are there, that is these four methods or any other series are there, you can also use the cubic equation are there, a plus bx plus cx square plus dx cube and so on. So you can use any one of them. So how you fit them? So this is a method we have discussed here. So finding the linear term. So I just firstly consider linear, and then I just move on the quadratic and others are there. So what is the linear is? I just consider a plus bx. Okay. So as I called as, you can also consider that ax plus b also. So you can replace the theory with. Okay. So what is that? This is the actual value, and my task is to find the line. That is a straight line. So one is the e is called as the estimated value, that is our target. So this is our target to find that. Okay, so that is that. So what is that? If I say this is there, so what is the value of this one is, this is the original value and this is my target value. This is y e, and the difference between them is called as the error. And my error, my principle of the least square is to minimize this sum of the squares of the error. So sum squares of their error. So y minus ye is called as the error. Okay, so I just substitute the value of the ye. What is that? Y is nothing but the a plus bx. So I just substitute that. And now my task is to minimize this. This is the e error. So my task is to minimize them. And everybody knows that. What is the principle for the minimization is? First derivative should be 0 and second derivative should be greater than 0. So since here how many unknown parameters are there? So you know that this is your year, so this is your sales. So say this is 2009, 2010 up to 2019, and these are the sales. So this is the year, I call it the x is my year, sale is my y. So y is known to you, x is known to you. The only unknown things are a and b are unknown. So how you minimize them? You can take the partial derivative of e with respect to a 0. Partial derivative of b with respect e with respect to b is 0. So how you know? You can take the partial derivative of this with respect to a is 0. So how you that? You know that derivative of x square is, if you take the derivative of x square is nothing but my 2x. So you find the derivative with respect to a. So what is that? This is 2 of this. 2 minus 1 is 1 into the derivative of this a, that is of the minus. So look at that, this is that. So principle is minimization is derivative of a with respect to 0, b is 0. So what is that? Derivative of a will be here. So I just take minus 2 on the right hand side, 2 is right hand side, so it becomes here. Okay. Similarly, if you derivative with respect to b, so what is that? Is square. So what is the coefficient of the b is minus of x is there. Okay. So I can expand this also as if you summation them. This is y. I can write this here is a plus summation of bx, and here I can write as xy is summation of ax plus summation of bx square. Now look at that. The value of this a is remain constant. It is independent of the index, so it will be by n a, where n is the size of their elements are there. So after solving, you will get these equations are there. So these equations are nothing but the normal equations. The first equation is corresponding to this. That is nothing but this is n a plus b is constant is outside this. While for the second is x y is a x plus b x square. So these are the equation of. So these equations are called as the normal equations of the linear light. Similarly, you can find the normal equation for the quadratic, cubic, and then so on. Okay. So I just give you one simple methods how to remember these normal equations are there. So in this case, you will see that y is known to you, x is known to you. So after solving these two equations, you will get the value of the small a and the small b. So once you know, after simplified, we get the value of a and b. So that trend equations will be by substituting here, you will get this. We will explain in the numerical examples, we will clear everything. So important tips to how to remember the normal equation, because here I have discussed the normal equation for the linear line. So if you want to draw the normal equation for the quadratic, cubic, and any others are there, you can draw it easily. So how you remember them? So I just again start with there. So normal equation is there. So how many constants are there? Look at that. A and B are my constants. Always remember they are x, y, and x are known to you, and A and B are the unknown. So what is the coefficient of the A? What is the coefficient of A in this one? That is 1. So multiply this equation 1 with this one. Okay. So remember what is the coefficient of A is 1. So multiply this equation 1 by the value and then summation. So what is that? If you multiply this equation by 1, the equation remains same, and put this summation sign. Okay. So what is that? So what is that value of A? So this A is, what is the summation of A? Since A is constant, so it can be outside summation of the 1. So what is the summation of 1 is nothing but the 1. So this is the first normal equation. What is the coefficient of B in it? What is the coefficient of B is my x. Okay. Now multiply this equation 1 with the x. So what is that? This is xy, ax, and bx square, and then put this summation in front of them. So what is that? This a is constant, so a can be outside, and then so on. So look at that. These two equations are called as the normal equation, and these are the same as we obtained by the principle of the least square method. Okay. So the normal equation for the straight line is same. After solving this, you will get the value of the AB and called as the trend equation. Similarly, for the quadratic, how many constants are there? A, B, C. So there are the three constants B. So what are the coefficient of the A is 1. So multiply this equation 2 by 1 and put this summation. So if you put this summation here, so this is N, A, B is constant outside here. What is the coefficient of the B is X. Multiply this equation by x, so it will be xy, ax, bx square, cx cube, and put this summation, you will get this. What is the coefficient of the c in here is x square. Multiply this by x square and put summation is in. So this and this are the normal equation of this quadratic curve. After solving, you will get the value of the abc, and substitute in the given quadratic equation, you will get the trend equation, and similarly for the others. So I just explained this with the help of the numerical example. So consider the following information. This is the year, this is the production. You have to fit the trend values. You have to find the trend values and the prediction for the year 2020. Okay. So if you look at this, so this is my 2010, this is 2012 and so on. And if you draw the graph of this is say 18, 20 and then so on. So this is the value of this. This is the value for 20. This is the 23. This is 23 and 16. So you have to draw the graph, either the straight line in such a way that the distance between them will be minimized. So look at that, the linear trend. So what is the linear equation is? Y is a plus bx. what is the normal equation of it is, you can easily draw them. Coefficient of A is 1, multiply this equation by 1, you can write it here. Multiply with the coefficient of the B is X, put them. So you can write it directly in your examination also. So it means, in here, you will, this is the normal equation, so you need the Y. So this is Y is given to you. X is always the year. Okay, so you need a Y, Y is there. So you need the sum of Y. You can calculate the sum of Y here. Okay, sum of the x, so this is x is there, so you can calculate that xy, you can multiply this, create a column of xy and put them their value, summation of x, this is use them, x square, so that is 2010 square, 2012 square and so on. So it means that process is very lengthy, because once you calculate the value of the x square, it means 2010 square, 2012 square, so the process is very lengthy. Also when you multiply this, this becomes 2010 multiplied by 18. So the calculation is very lengthy. So in order to avoid this calculation lengthy, so we make it easier so that the process and the calculation or the time consuming will be less. So how you then? You can construct the new X. Okay. And in this new X, you can write anywhere as a zero. Either you can write zero here, or you can write zero here, or you can write zero here. Okay. And so on. Instead of writing 0, you can write even any other number. For example, instead of the 0, you can write, start with the 4. You can write here, 4 here. You can write 4 here. You can write 4 here. Okay. You can write 3 even. You can write minus 3 even. Okay. It's depending upon you. So choose any number between minus infinity to plus infinity. Or you can write here minus. So it's depending upon you. Okay. The answer will remain the same. We will see that. Okay, so I just choose this number as a 0. So if you choose this number as 0, it means the corresponding this is called as my base year. Okay, so how you make them 0? It means you have to subtract x as a 2014 minus. Okay, so now based on this, you can calculate that means. So 2010 minus 2014 is now my minus 4. This is now minus 2. This is my plus of 2, this is now my plus 4. Okay. So always remember that you can choose any number, either you can choose x as x minus 2013. So what is that? Now this becomes minus 3, this becomes minus 1, this becomes plus 1, this plus 3, this is plus 5. Okay. So you can choose any one of them. But I always suggest you can choose according to this rule. So look at that. Is there any middle value of this? Look at that, 2 is upside, 2 is below side. So this is my middle number. So always choose the middle number. So that your calculation will be very small and very easy. Okay. So if there are say 2019 also, 2020 also. So what is the middle number is? You can skip 3 upside, 3 below side. So this 2016 will be my middle number. So it's depending upon you which method you can have to follow. So I always prefer you can choose the middle one. So look at that, 2 upside, 2 below side. So this is the below one. So this is called as the base year. Someone is called as the base year. Someone is also called as the origin. Okay. So once you choose them, so you can calculate the value of the small x. So look at that, the value of the x are there. Now what is that? You need a y. Y is there. X is there. Now you want to calculate the xy. So you have to calculate their x square. So calculate the xy. What is that? This is y, this is x. So you need to calculate the xy. So what is that? 18 into 4 minus 72. Okay. And so on. Xy is there. Summation of x. And you can easily calculate this. Now you need the x square. So construct a column of the x square. And then calculate the value. Okay. Now look at that. Y is there. This is there. And what is the n is? N is number of the elements, this 5, summation of x, this number, xy is this number, summation of x is this number, x square is this. All are calculated, now calculate the total. So what is that? These are total. Now substitute these values are here. So look at that, the normal equations are this, summation of y, look at the value of the summation of y is my 105. Now remember, this is not the x. Now you have considered all the calculation with the help of the small x. So this ends also. Look at that. From the first equation, this is 0. So value of a is easily calculated at 21. similarly for the B. Okay, now I have considered the 20 question as y is equal to a plus bx. So what is the value of the a is my 21, b is my 0.1. So this is called as the trend equation. Now, how to calculate the trend value? So this is the table we have generated, that you can construct the one more column. So this is the value of the trend value. Okay, so we can construct the trend value. So what is the value is this 21 plus 0.1x. So look at that, I can write here. So since all the calculations are based on this small x, so substitute the value of the small x here. So look at that, this how I just calculate 21 plus 0.1 multiplied with the minus 4. So the number is get to be 20.6. Similarly, you can calculate the values for the others. Okay, so these values are called as the trend values. So look at that, if you want to draw the graph for the year 2010, the value is my 18. For the year 2012, the value is 21, then 23, then 27, and then 16. And look at that trend value, so 20.6 for the year. So I can use the circle here, 20.8, I can use the circle here, circle this, and so on. So I can draw this dotted line are representing my trend values, and circles, these are my called as the original values. Now based on this, you can estimate the production for the year 2020. So look at that, the value of the x here, since I have calculated the value as 21 plus 0.1 small x. So what is the small x is x minus 2014. So what is the value of the small x is my x minus 2014. So substitute x here, you will get small x is 6. So substitute value here in this, you will get the value here, this one. Okay, so this is the production which are estimated in the year 2020. So look at that. So one beautiful note is that in here I have used the zero, I have used the 2014. But if you want to use 2014 as the base year, so then what is that? This is 0, this is 2, this is 4, and so on. And whatever the trend equation is there, this will be changed as compared to this one. So look at the previous one is my 21 plus 0.1x. While if you use the 2010, this trend equation will change, but the trend value remains the same always. Okay. Instead of that, if you use that 2013, again that's base year, then the value of here change, but trend values are remain same, but the trend equation will be changes. So what is trend value will always be same whatsoever the base year you have chosen. Look at the second example very carefully. So again there are some productions are there, look at the straight lines, and you have to find the monthly increase. So since the base, it is not given as base year, you can choose any one of them. So the linear equation is there, so this one is there. Look at that, this. So firstly you have to find the base year. So is there any middle value appears? Yes, 3 on the upside, 3 on the below side. So this is my base year. So I can consider this as x minus 2015. So look at that, x minus 2015. So this is my called as the base year. So I can calculate 12 minus 15 is 3 and then so on. And since my normal trend equation is this, so I need y, x, x square, and x. Okay, so I can construct here x, y, x, y. So look at that, my normal equations are this here, and x, y plus ax plus b of x square. Sorry, this is x, only x. Okay, so now based on this, you need a y, so y is there, x is there, you need xy, so now you can calculate the value of this is small x, y. So 77 multiplied by minus 3 and so on. So you calculate this, you calculate x care also, and then put their summation. So after that you can calculate their values. Again look at that, the value is 0. So a and b is there. So the trend equation is 89 plus 2x. After that you can calculate the trend values. So look at that, sorry, this is 89 plus 2x. Okay, so x is my this, so this number is calculated as 89 plus 2 of x minus 3. So 89 minus of 6 is 83, and then so on. Now the second part is, what is a monthly increase? So look at that, this is a monthly increase. Okay, so the trend equation we have calculated here is this. and where x is representing is in the year, okay, and y is representing in the production, that is in the sale. Let me check that. Look at that. The statement is y is in the year or production is in the thousand of the ton. So look at that, the monthly increase. So firstly we have to find the yearly and then we can convert the monthly. So increase, so whenever we are talking about the increase, we are talking about the slope. Okay, so what is the slope of this curve? What is the slope is nothing but the dy by dx. So what is the slope of this is 2, and this is a unit of the x, so this is in the year. Okay, so since the trend value increases with the rate of the 2, since is the y, this dy by dx is the 2, this is in the production of the 2000 tons. Okay, so that is the yearly production is 2000 tons. So the monthly will be divided by 12. Look at one more example is here. So again, now in this case, we have to fit the parabolic curve and then estimate the production for that 2020. So the parabolic, so since this is the parabolic equation, so a plus bx plus cx square, you can also use the ax square plus bx plus c depending upon you. So what is the normal equation is, so coefficient of the a is 1, so you multiply with the 1 and put this measure. What is the coefficient of the b is my x, multiply with the x here, so xy, ax, bx can, and so on. These are the normal equations. Now, so look at that. So these are given to you. So in this case, you need the y, xy, xy square, x, x square, x cube, xy cube, and x4. So I can draw a line. So what is the middle value? So you can skip 3 on the upside, 3 on the below side. So there is no middle value. Okay, so what is here? So the best way is, so you have to skip 3 on the upside, 3 on the below sides. So take the midpoint of these two values are there. So that is 2013 plus 2014 divided by 2. So what is the middle value is there? This. Or you can say find the median. Okay, so this, since this one. So you can write here as 2013.5. So what will happen? So once you calculate 2013.5, so this number will be my 1.5. Okay, but since it is a decimal part, so in order to avoid this decimal, I can multiply with a 2. Okay, so what is that? I can consider this as x minus 2013.5. Okay, it's totally on you. If you don't use this 2, then it's your choice. Okay, so look at that. If you can, this is 2.5 and here is minus 1.5, here is my 0.5, this is my plus 0.5, this is plus point and 2.5. so in order to avoid this decimal 2.5, once you calculate 2.5 squares, so 6.25. okay, 2.25. so in order to avoid the decimal, I have to multiply with this by 2 bit. So now based on this x, you can calculate x into y. So that is nothing but the 500 and so on. You can calculate the rest of values. Now put the values of the total. So you can calculate these values and substitute these values into these normal equations. So what is the summation of y? Look at that. Y is there. 848 and so on. So look at that. From here, you can calculate the value of b. And from these two equations, calculate the value of a and c. So these are the trend equations. Based on this trend equation, now you can calculate the value for 2020. What the equation you have used in the x is, look at that, 2 times x minus 13.5b. So now calculate the values for this. 2 times 2013.5. So for the x is here, you will get the 13. So after 13, substitute in this equation, you will get the values for the production. So this is the way to solve the method of the least square for the linear and the quadratics are there. So, but however, if the curves are instead of the linear and quadratic, the curve will be like a, b raised power x and so on. How you write the normal equation? Okay, and how to fit this one? For example, look at that. This one. Okay, so if you want to draw the normal equation, what is the coefficient of the a? What is the coefficient of a? This is b raised power x. What is the coefficient of the b? This is a. So look at that. These two coefficients. Coefficient of a is b raised power x. And this is a. These are not constants. Or these are the unknowns. Because they are depending upon the value of the a and b. And a and b still are unknown. it means the previous discussed method, it means you can't multiply with b of this. Look at that, my in case of the linear, what is the coefficient of a is 1, what is the coefficient of b is x, and these are the independent of a and b. So you have to multiply this by 1 and then x, while in this case they are not independent of a and b. Similarly, look at that, this for this curve a e raised power b x, what is the coefficient of a? This is e raised power b x. What is the coefficient of b? What is the coefficient of b is x. So it means again a is depending upon the b, so you can't apply the previous discussed method. Again, look at that, what is the coefficient of a is x raised power b, and b is yes. So it means how to solve this, so that will be considered in my next lecture. So in order to find the normal equation of this such type of the curves, we will study again the method of the least square, but how to draw the normal equation, that will be covered in the next lecture. So the normal equation of such curve can't be computed directly as in case of the linear and the nonlinear. So that is we will discuss in the next lecture. Keep follow them. Till then, you have to solve this linear and quadratic curves are there. I just put up the few questions for you. Before understanding the next lecture, you have to understand this lecture carefully. Study and learn the concept of the method of the least square with these numerical examples. Try hard. Feel free to ask me at any doubt at any time. Thank you.